17th chapter. The 11th verse. On the way to Jerusalem, he was passing along between Samaria and Galilee. And he entered a village. He was met by 10 lepers who stood at a distance and lifted up their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were cleansed. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice, and he fell on his face at Jesus' feet, giving him thanks. Now he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus answered, "Were not 10 cleansed? Where are the 9? Was no one found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" And he said to him, "Rise and go your way. Your faith has made you well." Amen. You may be seated if you can.
Amen.
Isn't God good? And then secondly, we look at that the unjust And we found out that the Lord not only is interested in the lost son, the lost sheep, and the lost silver, he is also interested in your service with respect to his money.
All right. Amen.
Oh, I think I didn't.
Amen.
Yes. He wants us to know without any uncertain terms that you cannot serve God and money.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I was convicted, and I'm sure that many of you were, if not all of you were convicted, that if the Lord gives it to me, he has a way and he has a right of telling us how to use it.
Amen.
Amen. This morning, I would like to transcend the parables that we have talked about and go to a real life story of Jesus on his way to Jerusalem. That is, picture, if you will, the fact that he is on his way to Jerusalem to be crucified. The 11th verse of the 17th chapter this morning is not a parable. It is an actual event. And we're going to see from our scripture and our text that God handles situations even though he may be facing death in just a few more days. We've got a chance to see something that I've seen over the last several months that have absolutely changed my direction in life. Just in looking at what I call the leper gang. The gang, G-A-N-G, of lepers. I wanted to put on my gang uniform this morning. So I saw myself as I prepared the dishes this morning. I saw myself with a bandana around my head. But I didn't want to scare anybody this morning. But visualize the leper gang that had a terrible and a ferocious weapon. And that is, they had leprosy. Have we got this? Whether they liked it, whether they would like each other or not, they would not do anything with anyone who didn't have the weapon that they had, which was the disease of leprosy. Have I got a witness? Now, just before you go too far with the message and get too far the other way, let me tell you that in this message, the subject is to let you know, would you receive the healing, the joy, and the peace of the faithful one? Have I got a witness? That is it, will you or would you receive what the thankful one, the one that went back to thank Jesus?
Mm-hmm.
Would you receive all that he got as a result? There are pork chops, steaks, and shortribs. and a mess of greens. What culture you would have to have leprosy. You would have to have, in that day and dispensation, you would have an incurable disease. Now remember that in the Old Testament, both Miriam as well as Nathan had leprosy. And they were healed by the Master. Have I got a witness? But now we've gotten into this dispensation where lepers as a gang were told that you had to stay away from everybody else by law. Have I got a witness? Well, but what does that mean, Pastor? It means that no one can come within of the leopard gang. Have I heard with this? If one approaches 149 feet, you have to holler and say, unclean, unclean. By law. Well, while I've got your attention, I want to let you know that Jesus don't have to come close to you, to heal and cleanse you. He can speak. Now we got a witness. The problem that I've had is that I believe that there are things in which the Lord has to do in order for me to get the blessings. But there are things that I've got to do to get the blessings.